All right, so you're in the house. You can hear a couple of people talking upstairs, some carpentry noises. Other than that, it seems like the lower floor is empty.
I'm just gonna sit down in the kitchen or something.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't know where Sahara is.
So are you two, do you need anything or?
I mean, I'm back at full health now. So, in terms of physical healing, I'm fine.
Do you need anything?
A croissant.
Possibly another drink, but
I think so.
oh, okay.
That's what I thought, yeah.
I go look around for what we've got in the kitchen.
There are no croissants. That's not a really big pastry in Bisseya's Teal. Unfortunately, they don't have the pastry variety that Rex and Trump does. But you find bread, you find I don't know, dried fruit, dried meat, cheese, nuts, probably like nut bread. They have butter, probably. I don't know. There are things to eat. No croissants, unfortunately. Jam. There's assorted alcohols. They have wine and fruit, or cider, fruit wine, stuff like that. Mead.
Okay, yeah, I will in an attempt not to overwhelm Antimony, I will just pick a drink to pour for her.
Just get me something. Something alcoholic, preferably.
Okay, as you're pouring Antimony an alcoholic drink of some variety, you hear somebody starting to come down the stairs. And Sahar kind of sticks her head into the kitchen. You're back.
You're back.
Did you find anything?
No.
No. Been a really long day of nothing.
Just not telling her?
You just spent, what, 6 hours looking around? You didn't find a single thing?
That's what we're telling you.
Surprised you didn't come back sooner. Anyway, make a
We're
deception check.
stubborn. Make a deception check, yeah.
Yeah, you gotta.
I figured.
You must.
Oof. okay. Not the worst.
18?
Yep.
Let's see, I don't think Sahara is super insightful. No, she's not. Let's see what she gets, though. No. Yeah, she just kind of shrugs, like, okay. Well, it's been pretty uneventful here, too. I slept in, practiced some sword fighting, you know, maneuvers outside, back, hanging out with your mom's girlfriend.
Sounds relaxing.
Yep.
Recovering from yesterday?
Yeah, I'm feeling a little less panicked.
Well, that's good.
Did you go talk to that jeweler? She asks Ophelia.
Did we?
You did not.
We went by there.
None of you did.
Did not talk to him.
No.
No. You didn't go inside or anything. You just kind of stared at the building.
I figured our vague threat was enough to scare him. I don't know.
But you didn't, like, try to get any actual information out of him?
Not really.
About whoever asked him to do that thing?
Maybe you should have come with us.
That's exactly why I didn't come in here. I thought you were going to send Adakora in there. That's what we told him we were going to do.
Yeah, but then we got distracted.
By what? Nothing?
And there was a cool lecture going on.
You didn't go to see Adakora's grandparents without me, did you?
Nope. Nope, we didn't even do that. You've really missed out on nothing. We're aimless without you, Sahar. You don't want to see what it looked like before we found you in the woods. Before you found us.
Just I did find you.
Long, lazy afternoons.
Well, all right. I'm probably going to have dinner in a couple of hours.
Maybe we see my grandparents tomorrow.
It's fine with me. I do want to meet them, especially if, you know, the rest of your family isn't all going to be there. And as long as Ophelia comes along.
Oh, Ophelia's coming along.
Are you inviting Eleni?
That's a good idea.
I know she really didn't trust me, but I kind of want to know what she's up to.
I really haven't seen her since we dropped her off, so.
Me neither.
I'll plan on that.
On what?
What'd
you say?
Oh, I said let's plan on that, referring to inviting Eleni to go to.
Yeah. Just waiting for Julie to finish typing. Okay. Grandparents.
You're talking about going to my grandparents.
Yeah. gonna bring Eleni along.
So yeah, we're going to a cool place.
Exactly. The coolest place. I haven't seen Melodora all day. I guess she's busy. Did you see her at all?
No, but that's not terribly surprising. There's a lot to be busy with.
True.
Sorry, what are we doing?
We're just talking to Sahar.
Yeah.
Okay.
Making small talk.
Sahar is making small talk.
We're bringing Eleni somewhere?
Yes, you've agreed to go to Atacor's grandparents' house tomorrow. Invite Eleni.
Okay.
Sahar says she'll only go if you go. And I said you would.
That's very ambitious of you.
You already said you were going to today, so.
You did.
You're
stuck. Well, I make no promises about tomorrow. Unless I said I would go tomorrow, and not today.
Well, you said you would go. You specified what time.
Fine. I guess. Good. You don't really need me, though, Sahar.
Eleni's. Yes, I do.
No, Eleni's gonna be there.
I don't want to be the only non-elf there.
Just, like, tape some paper to your ears. Make them longer.
You think that would make me... My ears are already pointed. That's not the issue.
Oh. Well, then they can't tell. That's, like, the only defining trait of an elf.
What about these? She, like, sticks her tusks out even farther.
Pretend you're sick and wear a mask, then they can't tell.
Oh. Yeah, but then when they try to talk to me in Elvish and I don't understand them, what then?
I'm pretty sure I can call in a favor with the Eleusis guy and get him to teach you comprehend languages for like a hot sec or even cast it on you.
No, I'd just rather you came with us.
Well, that's not ideal.
Don't inconvenience the Eleusis Dewin. Is that the council guy?
Yeah, I think so. I don't know, he's like some big shot.
Would not want you to inconvenience your very important friend.
Well, I so happen to be very important, so it would be no big deal, really.
Okay, well, I'm gonna go upstairs and tell Kalina that you're back. And she heads up. So you guys, if you want to do anything before we, like, cut to Melodora getting home, you can. If not, I'm just gonna skip to that.
I'm ready.
Yeah. I'm kind of... with my eyebrow raised at the others, just like, so we did nothing all day, huh?
We did nothing all day, and that's how it's going to stay.
Right, okay.
I'm just waiting to see how long you guys can keep that story up around Sahar.
Probably like 2 seconds.
That was a good save though, Ophelia. Yeah. That was close.
What was the save? What?
You being like, oh yeah, I bet I can ask Eleusis Dewin, my friend.
Oh yeah.
But you kind of saved it and made it sound like it was a joke.
Well, it was a joke, but...
Okay. No, I know, but... Sahar was like, sure, you know what loses to win, right?
Oh, yes.
Okay. Okay, so yeah, Sahar comes back downstairs after a little while, and then Kalina comes downstairs once she's finished kind of cleaning up. You get roped into helping her make dinner. It's mostly a lot of small talk. You get asked all over again how your day was and have to lie to Kalina about it. Although Kalina knew less than Sahar did to begin with, I think, so. Sahar, like, fully knew you were going to investigate the incident. And as you're almost done with making dinner, Melador gets home.
Does she look more stressed or different?
Make an insight check.
Okay. 19.
Okay. Yeah, Melodora is not, you've noticed this, she's not like great at hiding her emotions, and most of the time she doesn't really try either. It kind of seems like she's trying. She's not necessarily doing a great job. At least not with, like, your, you know, powers of insight. You spent a lot of time watching people. But she does kind of seem like she's trying to look less stressed than she actually is. Like, she just looks not even stressed, but, like, exhausted and kind of dejected. Is sort of the impression you get. But she's kind of trying to seem a little less down. Like, she's, you know, she's saying hi to everyone. She hugs Kalina. She gives her a kiss. She's like, oh, this smells amazing. I'm super hungry. Let's eat. You know, she's kind of like, she hugs Adakora. She goes and changes out of her armor, and you guys set the table, and everyone sits down to eat. Melador doesn't really talk about her day, and you notice Kalina doesn't really ask her anything, so. I mean, technically that's true.
That's right.
Ophelia is like, no, I didn't really die. When I really die, you'll know. Like.
Yeah.
The nature of D&D is when someone goes unconscious, it feels like they died.
Ophelia's like, I can't believe none of you know these things. Not being a cleric isn't an excuse.
So Kalina's not really asking about her day.
Nope. Yeah, actually, Melador probably sits down and asks Kalina how her day was, and that is maybe just a sort of signal with the two of them. Like, Kalina immediately picks up on that and starts just sort of, like, describing in great detail the commissions she's been working on. And, like, bitching about a client she has who's very picky and all that kind of stuff.
At some point, I start doing like the, oh, do you remember the time that, and it's like some embarrassing story about me when I was little.
Okay.
So take everyone's mind. Other thing.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Melodora definitely, like, gets into that.
Yeah.
What embarrassing story?
Yeah, what's the embarrassing story?
No. What are most of my childhood stories? There's so many childhood years to fill.
That's the thing with elves. Yeah. I think, God, Attacora's embarrassing childhood stories are probably like, there's like the dangerous ones where he like fell off shit and scared his parents.
Yeah, when I was learning to use knives.
Oh God, yeah, that was. Yeah. But like, your mom has healing magic, so it was mostly fine. Like, you didn't have any really close calls.
Yeah. Hmm. I probably had, like, a phase where I wanted to be, like, a druid so I could turn into animals.
Yes. So there's
some embarrassing stories about that.
Oh my God. Okay.
A lot of pretending to be animals.
A lot, yeah, a lot of that.
You went through, yeah, you definitely went through a pretending to be various forest animals phase.
Yeah, and then, like, a collecting of nature. Like, this is something a squirrel would have, so I'm going to take it home.
Yes. Oh, my God, yes. Like, this is my squirrel collection. I'm a squirrel mom.
Collection, like, my bird collection and my deer collection. And my
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
And, yeah, Melodora's like, I had to try to take stuff out without him noticing because there was just too much, like, his bedroom was full of piles of things, but if I took too much out he would notice. So I had to, like, slowly deplete each pile as he added things to it so it wouldn't fill up the entire room. Yeah, God, I bet Despina used to, like, turn into animals occasionally around the grandkids.
Oh.
That was probably a fun thing to do.
Yes, lots of asking for different animals.
Oh, God, yeah, absolutely.
Oh, what's that tweet? Mama, please turn it up.
Yeah. Oh, for sure. Exactly, yeah. Oh my God. Yeah, the conversation goes on like that. You guys get a lot of good, embarrassing young Attacora stories.
I will not let him live it down.
What?
I will not let him live it down.
I love that tweet so much. I saw someone use that for, like, Vets.
Vets,
and her,
yeah,
her kids. And I was like, but they could actually make that happen, probably with Keyleth's help or Allura's help. Somebody who knows Polymorph.
Yeah.
Yeah, and if nobody else, like, turns the conversation in any other directions, that's just kind of how dinner goes. Mostly reminiscing. And yeah, that's kind of what happens. You put everything away. And probably after everything is cleaned up, Melodora and Kalina go for a walk. So it's just you kids in the house. The three of you and Sahar.
Well,
well, well, well. And we have still not been contacted by wizards.
You have not. You have not heard anything from wizards.
Were the wizards supposed to contact us?
They didn't say that they would.
Okay.
That's true. They didn't say.
Nope.
I mean, yeah. Aethra said she would let us know what they decided, but that was before she went to talk to Eleusis, and we also went to talk to Eleusis, so.
Yeah, you guys know what they decided, at least. You don't know exactly what happened necessarily, but.
Yeah.
You know
we
what?
Might just have to find out, like every other plebeian in the city.
You might.
If Ludinus leaves, who knows?
It reminds me of my 3 weeks ago when we were trying to rescue a drow and heard about it in the papers. I think we heard about it in the papers. I don't remember.
I'm pretty sure the kobolds told you.
That's close enough.
It was longer than 2 weeks ago, because that was before we went to Blumenthal.
It was, yeah. But yeah, I'm, like, very sure that Torkel or Udala told you guys when they decided. Like, they did not keep you in the dark about that.
That's true. It feels equally distant.
It does feel like a long time ago. Well, it was for us. But yeah, it's, you know, 8 p.m. maybe.
I was probably writing down the stories that Adakora was voluntarily sharing. And like,
okay,
not smiling, but like having a hard time not doing it. I'm still grumpy, but like, this is good fodder for later. So Sahara's... I better.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
I just better record it.
Sounds good. So you're writing all that stuff down.
Yeah.
Sahara seems a little like. She doesn't like not believe that you didn't do anything today, but she can also kind of sense like a change in your moods a little bit. Like, you guys aren't really chatting as much. The atmosphere feels a little awkward for her. At some point she's just like, hey, anybody want to play cards? Like something like, you know, she tries to distract everyone.
That's sweet. I'll play cards with her.
Okay, you play cards with Sahar. She's good. Yeah.
I cheat.
Okay. You beat her, but only by cheating. You're like, if I hadn't cheated, she would have won. Yeah, and as the evening goes on, Ophelia, you hear a familiar voice in your head. It's not a wizard. It is your good old friend Torkel from the Kobold Soul. Oh, it's my best friend. And you just hear checking in. Do you have any news? An expositor is on their way to Bisseis Teal. Left late last night.
I'll go to the washroom or something.
Okay.
Just, I don't know, without saying anything, because
sure.
We're doing our rebellious teenage phase, I guess. Okay.
Oh, he doesn't say late last night. He says early this morning.
Okay. She was probably also writing potential sentences to Torkoal.
Okay.
While I didn't, of course, because, you know, why would I? Well, I did, but I just gotta tweak it. Okay, I'll say, we found out who and why. A selfish reason to bring Ludinus here and get an audience and become detained. Lucis and Aethra, wizards, no.
It's a while before you get a response. You just kind of hang out in the bathroom.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, it's like a couple of minutes. And then... Wait, I better type this out just to make sure. Shoot.
I'll probably, like, go out to make the motions of, like, getting ready for bed, because I imagine we're not going anywhere. So I'll, like, bring a change of clothes in. It's true. It's not out of the ordinary. Every minute that Torkoal doesn't answer is a minute that Ophelia feels better.
Oh, man. Okay, you're changing in the bathroom, and you hear in your head, the incident is resolved. Is it worth sending an expositor, or should I call our agent back? Awaiting a full report with great interest. The last sentence you gather means, like, he's interested when you can talk in person. Like, he's not asking you for more detail over sending, because that's difficult.
Mm-hmm. Word count. Damn, I'm good. Okay.
Was it exactly 25?
No, it was 23.
Incredible.
Okay. I'll say. Oh wait, no. The resolution is undetermined. Is there any way to get fast information on a Bisseus person disappeared 60 years ago? Ludinus contacted her before disappearance.
Oh my god. That's an even longer pause. Jeez, okay, let's see. Okay, it's another few minutes, a little bit longer this time, and you hear Tolko reply, "Possibly I can ask someone to look into it. Do you have a name for this person? Any other details?"
I have like a first name.
You have a first name, you know kind of like what sort of magical powers she has.
Okay.
That's kind of it, though.
Would it... sort of stand to reason that she might be in the same house that the... or she might have lived in the same house that the... they're currently in?
Yeah, sure.
And the name was Karya?
Macaria, yes. And you know a lot of elves in Bisayas Hill don't have surnames. So.
Right. And she was like, likely Shadar Kai?
Yes. And she was a sorcerer, and her abilities were called shadow magic. That was the, like, genre of sorcerer that she is.
Would she be, like, affiliated with the Shadar Kai, or is that just, like, a type of thing that someone is?
It's just, like, a type of creature. It's, like, elves who have been affected by the Shadowfell in some way, which, like, affected them physically.
Okay. And the two siblings are birth related.
Yes.
Okay. Then,
yes, they seem to have inherited that side of them, like their abilities from her.
Okay. Okay. Not a lot. Caria is a shadow magic sorcerer. Affected or whatever by Shadar Kai. Evander and culprit Metis are her children. Evander studied with Aethra.
Exactly 25.
Wow.
A Okay. He responds a little more quickly this time. Good to know. There aren't many with shadow magic on this plane. I'll talk to the researchers and let you know if we find anything.
All right, sounds good. No rush, except a lot of rush.
Okay. Oh boy.
Goodbye. Pet the cats. Thanks.
Okay. That's like the nicest message you've ever sent, Horkin.
Maybe I'm feeling sentimental because I could die at any moment.
Maybe. Okay, what are you guys doing? Oh, sorry.
No worries.
What are you guys doing while Ophelia disappears into the bathroom for 20 minutes? With her clothing and her notebook.
Besides playing cards?
Yeah, you don't have to be doing anything other than playing cards, but besides playing cards, if you are.
Like, probably. I would just be playing cards.
Yeah.
Okay.
If my mom comes back through, I want to grab her for a sec, but that doesn't have to be right away.
Yeah, she doesn't come back while Ophelia is gone from the room. But it's only been, like, an hour.
Yeah.
Since she and Kalina left. Okay, Ophelia, do you come back? Just come back and hang out in the room with the others.
Yeah, I'll try to beat Adakora at cards.
You
beating at cards makes me feel better. So as long as I'm getting away with it, I'm still cheating.
You probably get away with it until Ophelia joins the game.
Damn her!
You can't. She can't beat you, but she can tell that you're cheating. She might be able to... Ophelia's probably pretty good at cards. Like, better than you'd expect.
That's true.
Although, you probably know slightly different games than the ones Adakor grew up with.
Yeah.
But you catch on fast. You learned a lot of card games as a child. And you saw a lot of people cheating.
That's true.
You can definitely call Adakor out if you wanted to or not. It's up to you.
Are you guys betting on this? Is there money involved?
Samar doesn't have any money.
Oh. Well, he's still, I don't know, what's the term? Nope. It's not fleecing. It would be fleecing if there was money.
Oh my god.
If there was money, he'd be fleecing you.
That's true. He's just cheating. That's all.
Does playing games only bring you joy if you're winning?
Yes. Yes.
Is that like the only objective for you? Win at any means necessary, even if it means doing whatever you're doing? She probably pinpoints it exactly, but I don't care enough about cards to...
Yeah.
The objective for me is to play things that I can cheat at. So it's a challenge.
You've been cheating this whole time, says Sahar.
Well, yeah.
I think it would be more of a challenge. Hmm?
It's a compliment. I had to cheat to beat you.
Well, that makes me feel a little better. Here I was just thinking that you've been playing this game for, I don't know, 70 years, and that's why you were so good.
I mean, I have. That makes it sadder when you say it like that.
All right. I suppose I can forgive you.
I can't.
I appreciate that. Mighty big of you. See, she forgives me.
There's no forgiveness to be had here.
Sahar's, like, just a little drunk. Like, she's a little tipsy. This is honestly, like, the most, like, the calmest and happiest you've seen her, probably. Since you met her.
That you didn't tell her.
And Sahar.
Yeah, it's good that we didn't tell Sahar what we did today.
No, I'm talking to Sahar.
Oh, okay.
Huh?
If you want me to go to Adakora's grandparents tomorrow, you gotta rescind your forgiveness of Adakora and always hold him accountable forever.
Alright, then I do not forgive you.
Fuck you.
I no longer get joy from this.
That's exactly what I thought you'd say. And that brings me joy.
Alright, I'm going to bed then.
Good night.
Good night.
Don't, like, die or whatever on your way to bed.
I'm not that drunk.
Before you go, do we all want to go see if we can find Eleni together, or am I keeping elf hours on that one?
Elf hours?
Yeah, I think so. I wouldn't go to somebody's house this late.
Yeah, that would, like, make you a weirdo.
Although, I suppose, yeah, I suppose if they're elves, they don't think it's very late. I'm going to bed. You can go find Eleni if you want.
Out of character, I was thinking I could probably go to her place early and it wouldn't be a big deal because, you know.
For sure, like, yeah.
Before everybody else is waking up. All the humans.
Yeah, probably.
Eight hours.
Sahar asks you if she should leave the cards downstairs for you guys.
Sure.
Like, if you want to keep playing, she'll leave them downstairs.
I'll play with them, or at least fiddle with them.
Okay. Yeah, she leaves the cards on the table and she goes up to the second floor. You're finally alone.
Well.
Is that a cat? Are you stealing Sahar's cards?
No, but I was thinking about it.
Okay.
I think we did a pretty good job of finding the climate here. Though it might change in a couple of days.
Yeah, it's, I mean, it's, I don't know how this is gonna change things exactly, but hopefully the Empire won't start a war with Bisseus Teal, too.
That would be awkward. I don't think they would.
Nobody with sense wants to be fighting a war on two fronts.
It would be kind of unfortunate if there was a Kryn agent here too watching it and wanting to also stir up trouble. But that's probably not going to happen. We only been here for like 3 days.
Yeah, this is the end of day 3.
A lot has happened.
Yep.
And we're scheduled to go back like when? In like a week?
It'll take us about a week to travel back. And we can spend probably another week and a half here if we wanted to.
I guess we could. I mean, it's like a little nerd holiday or whatever. We could go to lectures and concerts and more lectures. Maybe not tomorrow, though, because tomorrow is a big day. I think we deserve only one task tomorrow.
That'd be nice, but Torkoal's probably going to call you back.
I wouldn't count on it. He's super stingy. It's not going to... Well, I mean, maybe.
I haven't actually seen evidence of that. You always say that.
What? He didn't send me any messages when we were in Hufferdoke at all, did he? No, because I complained to him about it.
Yeah, afterwards.
Did he know until then that you wanted him to?
Nope.
Well, I think
it was your first mission by yourself.
If my mentor cared about me, he would send me messages himself without needing to be prompted. But
you
now
can't always rely on everyone else to do the initiating.
Yes, I can.
Ophelia's entire life.
Yeah. Not excited to be initiated on in the future. I mean, it worked well. It works well enough for me with you.
Yeah, well, I almost got you both killed today, so I wouldn't say that.
No, that was kind of my fault.
You're creating a distraction for me.
I think the thing was my suggestion, so.
Well, then it's everybody's fault, I guess.
Yeah, so we might as well just, like, all die
so
right
we
now.
We can all blame ourselves, or we can all blame Metis.
True. Or we could blame Ludinus Deleth, which seems to me to be the obvious choice, because fuck that guy.
Yeah. Do you think someone from... Do you think a spy might actually come? If a Cobalt Soul person is? I don't know if we mentioned that to Aethra and Eleusis, but that kind of seems...
You did mention it.
It seems...
When we were right out of the way, when we were leaving Aether's house, we were like, by the way, we're from the Cobalt Soul, and there's an expositor coming, and probably also a Cerberus assembly member.
Yeah, but that, like, doesn't seem... I guess so. I wasn't thinking about the Cerberus Assembly as, like, a public figure. I was thinking about, like, an expositor-level person sneaking around.
Are you asking if we warned, out of character, are you asking if we warned Aethra and Eleusis that an expositor might come? Because you definitely did. Or are you asking about just anybody high level and sneaky?
I don't remember if Ophelia is, like, aware of the sticky nature of, like, the Augen Trust. If they're, like, tightly related to general fuckery.
That's a good question. Make a history check.
Okay. Natural 20 plus...
Oh my god.
My expertise, which... 26.
Oof. You're sort of thinking about spies. Like, what do I know about spies?
Not what I should.
You almost feel like the memory is, like, pushed back into your head. Like, you don't even have to reach for it. It's just there. Almost as if Ayun is helping you out a little bit. Yeah. You haven't heard a lot about the Augen Trust just because the Cobalt Soul doesn't know all that much. They've heard of it. They know the name. They know that, you know, that's the name of the king, like the spy network that answers directly to King Dwendal. And the Cobalt Soul is very sort of up on the conflicts between the different branches of the Dwendalian government. So, like, they know that the Cerberus Assembly is always a little bit at odds with the king and working towards their own various agendas, but also, like, has to stay in good with the king, otherwise they would be disbanded, all that sort of thing. And the Augen Trust, as far as you know, doesn't really have anything to do with the Cerberus Assembly. I don't think the soul knows exactly who the head of the Augen Trust is. I think that's pretty secret. But they know it has to be somebody in the king, like, direct inner circle, somebody who has the ear of King Dwendal, whether that's a public figure or not, hard to say. Mm-hmm. Whoever it is very good at keeping their identity a secret. But they are, yeah, this is not like the Scourgers. These people are at the king's, like, direct command, and they don't work for anyone else.
I see.
So they probably, to an extent, like, keep an eye on the Cerberus Assembly for the crown. Like, if anyone was going to do that, it would be them.
Mm-hmm. I forget what I was talking about before.
So do I, I'm sorry.
You asked either, did we warn Aethra that a spy might be sneaking around? You said, I wonder right. if a spy will be here. And then you said, did we warn Aethra
that people were coming?
Yeah, something like that. And then I got confused because I didn't know if you were talking about the expositor, which you did mention.
Right.
I don't remember you saying anything about Dwendalian spies at any point.
Yeah.
No, I don't think you did either.
You, like, threw out the possibility that there could be a Kryn spy around, but
yeah,
that's yeah.
about it, I think.
Okay, then.
And I don't know that you even talked about that in front of Aethra. I think that was just you guys.
Yeah, I think that was us, like, 2 seconds ago.
Yeah.
Okay.
But that's also probably, I think that was also, like, thrown around before you had really any idea what had happened. Like, that.
That it might have been Kryn?
Yeah, the possibility that the Kryn tried to kill the Starosta to, like, sow chaos in Visayas Teal.
Mm-hmm.
To try to get the Empire to, like, direct their attention to the north. But. Yeah, I think that's about as much as that's been discussed.
Okay, because, like, okay. Because it seems, like, in character, it seems like the thing is going to be resolved or whatever, but, like, what if there is a Kryn spy or person or whatever? Hanging about. I know I said this like 2 seconds ago, but like, what if? We could probably stick around a little bit longer for non-holiday purposes.
Torkoal's sending an expositor, right?
Yeah. So I guess we could leave.
I'd like to stick around a little longer, but.
Yeah.
I've done a lot of fucking around and finding out today.
Yeah. Not that that's, like, a bad thing, sort of.
the most Cobalt Soul response.
You almost died.
That's like the motto of the Cobalt Soul is fuck around and find out.
Like, yeah, but I didn't, so. Also, like, what? Okay, like, why didn't you start to run, Antimony?
At which point?
When you started getting fired on?
Oh, was this about, like, the first time when I was, like, just gonna try to do my stare off?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It was kind of a spur of the moment. Bad time for my issues with authority to kick in.
Authority. It's just very funny that she perceived not Sahar. I'm mixing up all my NPCs. Metis as and like the faceless person standing in the balcony as an authority figure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Antimony doesn't like to be intimidated into
No, doing. She doesn't. She doesn't. I know. It was just funny.
Okay. It didn't end super well for us, but I understand.
Why didn't you run?
Because I was fucking trying to help Antimony, excuse me.
You went down first.
I know. That was the fucked up part. I was gonna cast the spell and then start running, but then she was faster on the draw.
I think next time we run, or we make a concerted effort to fight. I don't like the way that went down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I know you two can fight. You saved my ass.
Today seems weird.
You don't say.
Maybe we should just sleep on it and get the next day going. Though if Torkoal messages me, I'll let you guys know. I'll probably tell him what went down. Because it's not like he's not going to find it out anyway, eventually.
Yeah, I know they said they weren't going to mention our involvement. But we did walk into the council room, so...
Yeah, I think that it might be sort of an open secret.
So yeah, it's probably best if someday somebody from the Paseus Teal Crowns Guard doesn't walk into Torkoal's office and say, "Hey, remember that time that your agents were in Paseus Teal and did stuff?" And he's like, "What the fuck are you talking about?"
Oh yeah, that's true. That's a good idea. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I will let him know. I'll also at least try to see if we can find out anything about the mom.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
Okay. What if we do find out information quickly? I don't know if it'll change anything, but maybe she can go face down Ludinus or whatever peacefully. Well, not peacefully, but like in her heart.
Find out if you want to find out, but don't find out for her.
I can have multiple reasons to want to find out.
She would have killed you. I know I'm stuck on that, but...
I mean, like, lots of people would have killed me.
He was just standing there and talking about killing you both. I am sympathetic. That doesn't mean I'm not angry.
Yeah. Oh. You didn't seem very angry when you were talking. But it's a good thing that you were talking, because I definitely should not have been talking. I successfully stayed quiet. I think I definitely would have gotten us killed for sure. And I guess it's not so much sympathy for her than it is for the other guy, because he's kind of nice. I mean, like, he's decent.
We do owe Evander.
Yeah.
It's easy to get wrapped up in stuff. Because you believe in someone or something, even though it's not what you would actually do. So it's nice that it could be nice to get it resolved in a manner that doesn't end with him losing all of his family.
I wonder if he'll want to stay here if she's gone.
It depends how she's gone, I suppose.
We could offer to take him back to Rec Center with us, but I don't know what he'd do there.
Grow resentful. This close to the servers assembling, you can't do anything.
Maybe he can. Like Alusa said, no one's looked for her yet. No one's left the city to look for her.
That's true.
Something to think about.
He could be a contractor like Antimony. We should at least suggest that to him, because it would be pretty good for me to have recruited two people to the Cobalt Soul.
Yeah, do you get a bonus when you do that?
No. Torkoal doesn't even say he's proud of me, so. Did I bring them qualified people who are ready to bring what they have to the organization, or did I just bring them another mouth to feed? Sorry, Antimony. I know your quality, but like Evander.
Yeah, I honestly, I don't know if he'd want to come with us anyway.
Probably not. We can at least tell him to let him know what we'll find. We'll let him know what we find.
Yeah.
Also, I'm pretty sure that when you recruit people to the trust, then they're my mouths to feed, because I feed you and I feed Antimony.
Did you deliberately mean to say the trust?
What?
You said when we recruit people to the trust.
No, I didn't say that.
Amazing.
Imagine if that was how it came out.
God. We've been playing for a long time.
Yeah, I'll let you retcon it. It's fine.
Woof.
That would be funny though. That would be. Ophelia was like, excuse me? Yeah. Ophelia was just thinking about the trust like 5 minutes ago.
Kill me now.
Did you like get a spike of dread when that happened?
Yeah.
First of all, the Cobalt Soul is paying you to pay for my meals, so.
I but they didn't pay me more, so.
How do you know?
They're not the ones suffering.
You're suffering? Excuse me? It is a privilege, first of all, to be able to buy things for me.
You know how many things I could be buying for myself when we go places, and I don't, because I'm buying us all food.
Do you want, like, a gold? I can hand it over.
No.
Well, then, shut the fuck up. Besides, I think maybe they do pay you more, because I mean, you have to feed me.
They've been paying me more since I stopped being a research assistant.
Well, before you were a research assistant who was buying me food, and now you are a research assistant traveling who also buys me food. So it's just like the same tier, but with the addition of also... Because, I mean, have you asked the other assistants what their salaries are?
That's kind of rude.
You're just a part of the system. A gullible fool.
Do they encourage pay transparency in the I feel like they probably do.
Adakura assumes they don't, so he's...
okay.
No idea.
I feel like Ayun is very pro
pay. Yeah, I feel like they would...
That's just a feeling I have. Like, you could probably look up what everyone makes in the records.
Yeah.
Which is why people don't really talk about it.
Yeah. You're getting fleeced. Robbed.
Well, maybe it's no more than what I deserve.
Exactly.
And you did get me the field agent job, so... It all comes around in the end.
I didn't do that because of you. Oh wait, yes I did. I forced you to come with me.
Yeah. Multiple times.
Well, it's not my fault that you like me, so... I think they only gave me a choice because they knew that I would go straight to you. So is that really me making the decision, or is that the Cobalt Soul just, like, trusting me to make the right decision?
Do any of us have free will, or is everything ordained?
I'll have to ask my sticks about that.
I don't know, why don't we just go see a lecture?
Just ask Alinea about it.
That's probably the start of her campaign. To figure out the truth of free will and independence and... Well, I'll keep you updated if Torkoal sends a message or whatever. If he has the precious spell slots for it. But otherwise, I'll join Zahar, I guess.
He literally sent you 4 messages, I think. It was a lot.
Yeah, what's your point?
Yeah, he sent 4 messages.
And I'm very grateful.
That's 4 third level slots.
He doesn't even have 4 third levels.
You don't have any third levels.
I know. It's a crime.
Okay, you go upstairs to go to sleep. Sahara's out. She's snoring.
Okay, I will follow her lead.
All right. What do you two do downstairs? Go to bed?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, Antimony goes to bed. Atacora, you're gonna turn in early, wait for your mom.
I'm still waiting for my mom.
Okay, it's a while. It's like another hour maybe before she gets back. She and Kalina get back. They both look like they've been having a serious conversation about something, but they don't look too upset. Just kind of like solemn when they get back. Oh, your friends went to bed.
Yep.
Kalina just kind of looks at you two and is like, I'll give you guys some some time to talk, and goes into the other room.
Try to figure out how to phrase it.
Yeah. Hey. She goes to her and Melodora's bedroom and closes the door. You look like you had a long day.
Yeah. I know you're busy with all this crap, but promise me we'll at least try to get out to the woods while I'm here. So I don't want to think anymore.
No. Of course, I'm not gonna give you the details because I'm not supposed to, but I think this whole thing is going to come to a close pretty soon.
That's good.
Then I'll have more time.
Well, I should still be here for a little while.
All right, let's say day after tomorrow.
Okay.
You all right?
I don't know. Kind of thought I had a handle on things, but humans move so fast.
Do they?
I'm being serious. They do.
Maybe that's why the title finds them so interesting. There's like no resentment in that. She just like is amused.
Well,
yeah. He comes over and gives you a hug.
Put my head on her shoulder.
I'm sorry all of this happened when you visited.
It's fate or something, I guess. I'm not very religious.
I know. I probably wouldn't be either if I'd lived in the Empire for any length of time. The real Empire.
That's a depressing way to look at it.
It's a depressing place.
Not always.
I know. I'm sorry, I had a long day too. Are you going to take your friends to see your grandparents?
That's the plan for tomorrow.
Good.
Ophelia was finally convinced through the power of spite.
She's funny.
They said you were funny. It's a compliment.
Yeah.
It's Mari.
She keeps things interesting. Like I said, they move fast.
Well, I know. Things didn't really work out with that other girl.
I mean, we're still friends.
No, that's good. But I mean, do you like Ophelia that way?
We're friends.
All right.
I'm pretty sure if I made romantic overtures, she'd stop talking to me, so...
Well, if you think that, you're probably right. So, I think that's the smartest move. It does make me sad to think of. You falling for someone who's not going to be alive for very long. But I suppose it happens.
Dad did it. But I don't know how it's gonna be. I mean, no one does.
No. Nobody who hasn't been through it can know, I suppose. Oh, well.
I think why he left, but, you know. There's a lot of things about him I don't get.
Me too. But I'm glad he's happy.
Yeah.
I just hope it's not too hard on him in the end. But at least he'll have you, I suppose. I can't believe Antimony's only 24.
I know.
I know. Yeah, she's like, she's so old. She looks so old, but she's only 24.
Yeah, that's how it's weird. Yeah. It's weird. You leave Elf City and you go into a time warp.
Right? Yeah.
Everything happens so fast. Everything changes.
Anything else bothering you?
I mean, that's most of it, I guess. I don't think we're made for things to change so fast. All left behind. So.
Well,
I'll move back here someday.
Yeah, if you ever feel too left behind by the human world, you can always come back. I'll be here.
I love you, Mom.
I love you, too.
I'm gonna get some sleep.
All right. She gives you a kiss on the forehead. Oh. You're gonna make me sad, Julie, thinking about Ophelia. Okay. Yeah, she goes into her bedroom.
Yeah, don't stay up too late. Get your 4 hours.
Right, yeah. Yeah, it's a little later now. It's like maybe, I don't know, 11 p.m. to midnight, something like that.
Yeah, so I will go back to my room. Okay, everything. Do I call on Alora tonight? And I still haven't decided.
Yeah. You can decide next time if you want. Because I don't really want to go through that right now, to be honest. It's getting a little late. We've been going for a while. Yeah, but you do... It kind of occurs to you at this point that she hasn't tried to call you yet. So different from yesterday, where you got paged like 4 times before you finally called her.
Yeah, I just kind of sit on my bed and take out the stone and turn it over and don't use it.
All right. Okay, I'm gonna call it there.